That deal, how real is it? The process, the production of making a film in partnership using your technology?
Yeah, so it's a first of its kind of deal. And the idea behind it really is to take the Lionsgate team further with the technology. Like, we're at the crossing point where AI is becoming really useful for filmmaking. Mm-hmm. And so what we really want to make sure is that we help creatives, filmmakers, artists, studios really understand how to use it in the best way possible. And so what we did with Lionsgate, it's, I think, something we've been trying to do for a long time, basically to bridge the gap between AI and Hollywood and bring this technology in much more accessible ways to many filmmakers.
Cristobal, as you know, I love the detail of things. Are we talking about filmmakers at Lionsgate sitting at a computer using your software as part of their process?
Yeah, that's kind of the point. There's many tasks in the development of a movie where you can embed AI or our models and make that cheaper and faster, right? Okay. So if you're iterating through storyboarding or pre-visualizations or visual effects, you can use our models, and filmmakers are now understanding how to use these models in ways that are very useful for them, right? But I think that's the key aspect of it, which is, for a long time, AI has been seen as this kind of like system that creates movies on its own, right? And it's really not like that. It's really a tool for directors and filmmakers. And with the Lionsgate deal, what we really want to make sure they understand is that they can take that further for their movies and becomes a really cost-effective tool to use. So again, if you're spending hundreds of dollars in making a shot, in making a visual effects a scene, you can now use Runway to kind of reduce that cost and move faster and to better results.
You've been improving your models.
Yes.
How costly does that become remain?
There's definitely research that has to be done to train the models on the first end, but then running the models and using them has become much more cost-effective over time. Mm-hmm. And I don't think we're yet at the point where you will see an optimization. Like, we're going to optimize the models even more, so the cost of running them will be even cheaper and faster.
Let's just talk a little bit about, therefore, as you're building your offering, you're winning over new clients like Lionsgate. We think about where we were this time last year. We think about Hollywood in strike mode because of artificial intelligence. Yeah. What sort of conversations have you had to have to get people comfortable with this technology?
Well, the first thing that I think is important to remember is that Hollywood is the history of technology. Like, we are here because of a technological breakthrough, right? And so we sometimes forget that art and technology kind of like come together always. And for us, it's like demystifying a little bit the technology. Again, if you understand AI as a tool for humans, then it changes the narrative. And it's less about fearing it and more about embracing it, and you realize how you can actually use it. And I think what we need to do right now is kind of like educate more and show the potential. There's also challenges of the technology. It's not a perfect kind of technology. It's not a perfect tool. There are things that are not exactly working as they should, but that's kind of the point. As you need to improve them and make it even better. And I think part of it is just like showing more people, more producers, more Hollywood studios, really the potential of it and use it.
Cristobal, Caroline and I use text-to-text, text-to-image, text-to-video tools every day. I love technology, but I also just love film.
Yeah.
And there comes a point where I just want to ask if AI really can give the same feeling, create film and movie and content that is as authentic as the great filmmakers can make it with their hands and their eyes and camera. What do you think about that?
Well, the interesting thing is filmmaking and stories and art are never really about the technology, are about conveying a feeling, an emotion, are about connecting with the viewer and telling and making you feel something, right? You never watch a movie because how it was made, right? Or the cameras that were used to make the movies, right?
You're a real nerd like me, yeah.
Yes, but maybe even though, like, after the fact that you've liked the movie, right? You can go deeper into how it was made, but 99% of the world watches a movie because they feel something, because they connect with it. And so AI, if you think about it as a tool, can help you kind of connect with your audience, can help you deliver that message, can help you tell a story.
Yes.
And so right now, I think we're fascinating by the technology itself, because it is fascinating. It's revolutionary. It's changing the game. It's incredibly new and exciting. But at the same time, if you want to focus on art and filmmaking, it's important that we switch the narrative to storytelling, to people and how they use it and how they convey stories with technology, and less about which AI or which technology was used behind the scenes.
You've been telling stories to raise money. And you've got some really interesting investors, because not many of them are going to be in the world of art and creation. In fact, you've got NVIDIA, Salesforce. What do they want to see out of you? Why do you have these sort of strategic investors coming on like an NVIDIA, and what do they earn you?
Well, I think they are telling stories, and their users are also telling stories. Like, again, you can think about storytelling as Hollywood, as media, as films. But if you think about companies are also telling stories when they're advertising, when they're doing marketing, when they're communicating with the users. And so if you can help them also deliver better messages, then that's also a form of storytelling. Perhaps it's not as the art kind of like form, but it's still like a form of video. And we want to make sure we can work with companies like that are great and have been great partners for us for a long time.
For at least a year, I've been hearing about Runway, and your name comes up a lot. OpenAI has Sora. On the show in the last week, we talked about Meta's new tool.
Yeah.
But you have a very singular focus. Where do you think you stand in your competence and as a business relative to that competition of OpenAI and Meta?
Yeah, look, when we started this 7 years ago, it was a very new field. And I think we've proven over time that it's a really exciting and worthwhile field to spend time in. It's an industry that's going and it's changing. And I think when you create a market and you create a good opportunity, you will have competition. I think it's unreal to think that no one else will try to build what we're building. But at the same time, we're very much in the long-term horizon strategy. Like, everything we're building is not really about video today. It's around everything else that we can build to create better tools for storytellers all over the world. And so video is only a first kind of like stepping stone, but working towards audio, towards images, towards 3D, just a collective system, a collective set of tools, an AI system that can help you in all forms of storytelling that you want to tell.
Will you raise some more money for that long
term? We will have to do whatever we have to do to deliver on that mission.
You will have to, won't you?
We've been kind of like raising almost every year from now since we started 7 years ago.
An IPO?
We're just focused on building right now.